Okay, I gotta get myself ready. Me, 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 me. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. A deer, a female deer. Okay, wait, stay focused. Focus, getting your voice ready. My throat is feeling parched and it's dry. I'm thirsty. Water. Someone throw me some water. Anywhere. Somebody. Go ahead. Oh, that's a lot of water. Okay, this, huh? Okay. Yeah. I don't know. I don't know. So that's actually, maybe that's enough. I don't know. How? Is this right? Am I doing this right? No, everyone's looking at me like I'm crazy. Is this how you warm up your voice? Deep breath. You got this. You're gonna kill it. You're gonna do awesome. You're gonna sing that song. You are so good. You got this. Yeah, I got this. Yeah, I could do this.
Okay, guys. Well, I don't know. I feel like I'm warmed up enough. Yeah, I think we can get this started. Yeah, what do you guys think? Get started? Yeah. 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 Okay. My name is Pastor Ivalani, and as you see, I am getting my vocals ready because for our series Sing, we're actually gonna be doing some singing today. It's really exciting. That's how we're gonna close out our series. Yes, I know, I cannot believe we're coming to the end of this awesome series. We have learned so much about the book of Psalms, like how God keeps us safe and he protects us and how much he loves us, even guides us and directs our path. I feel like I have learned so much about the love of our great God. But you know what I really feel like is the huge takeaway from this entire series? Is that we need God. That's right. We need him, like really, really, really bad. We need to be filled with him, because if we're not filled with him, what are we filled with? Good question, right? Today, we're gonna learn all about that. And I actually want us to open up our Bibles. That's right, grab your Bible. I'm gonna grab mine. Handy dandy Bible. That's right, open it up to Psalms 42. Okay, go to the book of Psalms. Everybody get there, get there, get there. Okay, oh, mine's marked. All right, now go down, use your finger, go down to verse 11. All right, I'm there. Are you guys ready? Okay. It says, why, my soul, are you downcast? Which means to be sad. Why so disturbed within me? Put your hope in God, for I will yet praise him, my Savior and my God. See, that was saying that, why is our soul sad or feeling empty? That we should be putting our hope in God, who fills us up and makes us feel awesome and gives us everything we need. We're going to be focusing on Psalms 42 today. It's gonna be great. Now, with all that being said, I have my friend Abby here today. She is so cool, and she actually has something she wants to talk to you about. So I'm going to flip it over to Abby.
Oh, hey guys. I was so thirsty. Have you guys ever been so thirsty that you started to not feel very good? And you knew you just needed something to drink. And I mean anything to drink. Did you guys know that we get spiritually thirsty too? Yes, our souls actually get thirsty. Just like our physical bodies need things to keep us healthy, it's the same way for us spiritually and emotionally. Now, remember when I said before that when you're thirsty, you just need something to drink and you'll just go for anything to drink? Well, do you think that a soda would be the best option when you're really thirsty? I mean, it might be super tasty for a second, and maybe even refreshing for a moment, but would it really be something your body needs in that moment when you're so thirsty? No, it definitely wouldn't. What would be the best option, do you guys think? Shout it out. Water, yes! Water would be the best option. Not only would it satisfy your thirst, but it would also give you exactly what your body needs. Spiritually and emotionally, we're all gonna get thirsty sometimes, but God wants us to quench our thirst by filling ourselves with Him, not something that's only gonna temporarily satisfy us or not even really be good for us, just like this soda. Jesus is the only thing that can satisfy our souls, just like this water. Well, guys, I gotta run. I'm gonna go meet my friends. We're actually gonna sing a song for you guys called Psalm 42.
Quench our hearts and fill them.
My friends did such a great job singing. I guess I missed out on the singing part, but it was probably best to leave the singing to the professionals. I thought they did a wonderful job. What a beautiful song, all about Psalm 42. Gosh, God's word is just beautiful. And I really love how all of my friends used their gifts and talents to praise our Lord and Savior. This lesson has been so great learning how God fills us up. Like Abby said, spiritually and emotionally, we're gonna get thirsty and we wanna be filled with the right stuff. And that's Jesus. He is the only answer. But the world will offer us other things that might make us feel like we're satisfied or we're filled up. But you know what? It just won't last. The world can't give us what we truly need, and we need Jesus. Plain and simple. And when we can understand that, our soul will be truly satisfied. Man, our God is so good, and that is something to sing about, give praise to, and give Him all the glory and honor. I'm just so glad that we got to focus on the book of Psalms, and what a beautiful book it's been, right? Filled with poems, poetry, and just beautiful prayers. All of the talented people who put together the book of Psalms, man, they really showed how great our God is, and I love reading all about it. So guys, now that we know that we need Jesus, I want to give you the opportunity to accept Him as your Lord and Savior. That's right, make Him Lord and King of your heart. So if that's you right now and you're feeling empty, but you want to be filled up with Jesus, on the count of three, I want you to lift your hand. Okay, and we just do that to say, I choose Jesus. It's just a public statement. Are you ready? Are you sure? Are you really, really sure? Okay, here we go. 1, 2, 3. Wow, look at all those hands go up. This is really, really exciting. Okay, so now we're going to say a prayer, which is talking to God. It's really simple. But remember to put power in your words as you talk to Him. All right, close your eyes and bow your head. Dear Heavenly Father, I love you and I thank you for sending your perfect Son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross for me. I believe in my heart and confess with my mouth, you are my Lord. I ask you to forgive me of all my sin. And Lord, please fill up my empty soul. We pray all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen and amen. Way to go. All right, do a little celebration, right? Little raise the roof, right? Or even just give yourself a round of applause. Yes, that's very, very good. Wow, way to go on accepting Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Oh man, this series has been so much fun learning all about the book of Psalms, guys. Thank you so much for joining me. Well, that's it for me today. I will see you guys later. Bye.